My basic philosophy of care is to treat a patient the way that I would want to be treated or the way that I would want a family member to be treated if we were in the same position. And that has multiple parts to it. It starts with taking the time to listen to the patient and understand what's bothering them and where they hurt. It carries through to a thorough examination, actually taking your time to examine a patient the way that they need to be examined in a very thorough way. That philosophy carries through to the operating room on the relatively small minority of patients who I see who actually need surgery. It carries through to the period after surgery. At the end of the day, with all of the new technology that we have, improved imaging studies, there's still no substitute for taking time to listen to a patient, examine a patient, and personally study their films, and then look after them the way that you would want somebody to look after you. I figured out pretty early on in medical school that I was some sort of surgery, some surgical field was going to suit me better than a medical field. I really am drawn and was drawn at that time to the idea of evaluating a patient and then putting in place a definitive plan to structurally and permanently treat a problem, to fix something. I found that very satisfying. I grew up here in the Jackson area in Rankin County, and when I graduated high school, went to Mississippi State and majored in biological engineering there. After that, I went to medical school at Johns Hopkins University School of Medicine in Baltimore. And then I was fortunate enough, upon completing medical school, to be able to stay and do my neurosurgery residency training program also at Johns Hopkins. That was technically 6 years, with the last year of training being a faculty position. So I was an instructor in the Department of Neurosurgery for a year before I moved back home here to Mississippi and joined actually one of the original founding members of NewSouth NeuroSpine as well, all the way back in 1999. It's hard to believe that I've been back home that long. My favorite thing about what I do is treating patients who have a really debilitating spine problem that is affecting their life in a profound way. And it's just a joyful thing for me to take somebody to the operating room with one of those problems. And in typically a relatively straightforward, uncomplicated, if carefully done procedure, cure them. Just absolutely eliminate that pain. It's a non-traditional pathway into medicine to do engineering in undergraduate. And State's biological engineering departments is superb, and it actually is geared towards helping people go to medical school. They have a very strong pre-med track there, but that's unusual. When you look at the total number of physicians that are out there and the typical majors that people are in, it's important to me because I feel like even today it helps me in my everyday practice. The big picture of engineering is learning to think logically through a complicated problem. And that's a big part of what I do every day in this office.